Hey guys, and welcome to SeaWorld. We just got here. We're here a little later in the day than we usually go. And that is because Electric Ocean is going on. Now, Electric Ocean is SeaWorld's summertime, nighttime spectacular. There's a special sea lion show, a special dolphin show. Of course, Shamu has his own show. So lots of special shows. I think there's like a special bar and snacks that will be here for Electric Ocean. There's dance party, so it's a really fun celebration for summer. Now, Electric Ocean goes until September 1st. It happens every night all throughout July, and then around mid-August, it starts to happen just over the weekends. So let's get inside and let's see what Electric Ocean is all about. Something I wanted to point out is that there seems to only be one showtime per these special shows. So you can see 5:30 is the time for Touch the Sky. So if you do want to see everything that Electric Ocean has to offer in one day, you're gonna have to really go from place to place to place and really plan your evening here in the summertime at SeaWorld.
As the sun begins to dance on the horizon, we become the spark that ignites the fire of SeaWorld's Electric Ocean. But I'm not really sure what we should do next. Do you know what line we should get into?
Me neither.
I sure wish SeaWorld had one of its employees that could tell us where to go.
If you bought your tickets online, stand on the third line to the left. If you bought your tickets from some guy in the parking lot, stand in the fourth line, next to the first line, behind the shrubs, but in front of the second line.
Gotcha. Who needs a park map anyways? Let's go see Pets Ahoy!
Ladies and gentlemen, it is such a privilege for all of you to meet me.
Done with the dolphin show and the sea lion show, Touch the Sky. It's just so beautiful. Like, I almost got choked up at the end just seeing all the dolphins jumping together. And the way it's choreographed, the way they have the dolphins trained to jump at the exact right times to sync up with that music is just amazing. It's a really, really beautiful show with great music. The Sea Lion show is not what I expected it to be at all. It was basically SeaWorld poking fun at itself for 20 minutes. They make fun of security. They made a reference to a monorail. Two very different shows, but both very, very good. And really start Electric Ocean off on a really good note. So we're going to continue on around to Shamu Stadium, where I'm assuming a lot of the special stuff will be. I had read that there was a special bar as part of Electric Ocean. It's called Club R&R. It looks like it's inside this Nautilus Theater. Looks like they have a bubble area in this area you can play around in. And then it looks like over in that corner over there is the actual bar where you can purchase drinks. They have some light up tables here that are kind of cool that you can hang out on, and just got really dark and quiet in here. I noticed these planks of wood right here. You can see one. There's another one right there. It just looks like another hard surface for you to set your drinks down. I don't think any special shows or anything happen on that stage up there. I think this is just a cool, literally and figuratively, place for people to hang out and take a break from the Florida sun. I didn't even notice these cool screens that they have up here. They're showing jellyfish on them right now, but I've never seen the Nautilus Theater like this, like a club environment. You can see right here that they do have a place for you to charge your electronic devices too. So yeah, definitely a place to grab a drink, charge your devices, and just cool off and hang out. Here's the menu inside Club R&R. It does look like they just have drinks and stuff like frozen fruit pops in here as well. It does look like they have a little hopscotch area as well. Actually, look at that. There's actually like gel inside these, so when you step on them, it moves around. It does look like these specialty drinks come in these special glasses here, also in that those bright neon colors. It's like it says Electric Ocean on it. SeaWorld is running a really good perk for pass members right now. If you scan your pass at one of the kiosks in the front of the park, you get a free $10 SeaWorld bucks to use in the park. It is important to note that it is only valid on the day you are in the park. So make sure to grab a souvenir, some food while you're in the park if you grab this. I think I am definitely going to come back to this food stand to get a snack. You may recall we had this donut ice cream sandwich before at the Seven Seas Food Festival. And it was all right. And I was planning on trying it again today with a new topping around the edge like that. But then I saw this, these loaded mini donut bites, and that is something that I really, really want to try, I think. So we may be back here unless we see something really good on our walk around. Really cool photo op right here, Electric Ocean, SeaWorld. I am surprised that none of these kind of permanent food booths that are up for the Seven Seas Food Festival are serving any food. But I do like that they decorated them at least for this Electric Ocean event. The dance party at Bayside Stadium is actually called Club Seaglow, and that opens at 8 p.m. There was just an announcement made on the bridge and we saw all those puppets come out. Here are these loaded donut bites. I did not get the caramel on them, but it's got chocolate sauce, whipped cream, nuts, and a cherry on top. Let's dig in. I was originally hoping for ice cream on here, but the whipped cream is perfect because the donuts are rich. They're very fresh, so soft, they're warm, so against the coolness of the whipped cream, it's delicious. This is a lot better than that donut ice cream sandwich, and I'm really happy I tried it. We'll be right back. Wow, so we are finished with Electric Ocean at SeaWorld Orlando. That show was really intense. I feel like that was like a fireworks show on steroids. It just had every effect you could ever want. Lasers, the fire, pyro, the water fountains. It was amazing. There was so much to look at. I feel like I could see that show again. When we were down in that dance area with the DJ and all the puppets, that was a legit party down there. It was so cool. We actually sat up in the stadium to kind of watch it from afar and to see the lights interact with the neon outfits that the puppeteers and dancers were wearing was so cool. And it's important to note that you can watch the fireworks from down in that dance floor area. I assumed they would clear it all out, but you can watch it from down in that dance floor, which I think would be a really great vantage point because some of the higher fireworks were blocked by the overhang that we were under. So just a little tip if you want to get really close to the action. But wow, we did everything we wanted to do with Electric Ocean. I will say that if you have one day at SeaWorld doing all of the Electric Ocean activities and all of the rides and all the other shows that happen during the day, on a busy day like it was today would be a lot. You're going to be running around. It would be a lot. We literally just did all the Electric Ocean stuff. We were here from about 4 something to closing at 9:30. All we did was Electric Ocean stuff. So it would be a lot if you just have one day here at SeaWorld to try to do all of that. So maybe pick and choose what you really, really want to do. That nighttime, the Ignite show, the fireworks show is a do not miss, though. That was really, really cool. Well, thank you so much for joining us here at SeaWorld Orlando for Electric Ocean. I can't remember if we've ever done this event, but I'm so happy that we made it here this year, and I definitely don't want to miss this again in the future. Well, if you enjoyed this video, think about subscribing and joining us for more adventures around Florida. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up and turn on your notifications so you always are the first to know when we have a new video out. Thanks again for watching and make sure to follow us for more on Florida.